innocent girl Christina, orphaned at 15. She was dead and almost buried when her body floated up to the ceiling of the church, to the witnesses who saw this act of levitation. She offered to the crowd this modest explanation: I had to rise above the smell of all that sin, because I could not stand the stench of those awful men. And stranger still was what she said had been revealed to her when she rose up to the rafters in her holy rapture. The angels showed to her the world that awaits, heaven and its joys, the torments of hell and hate, almost as bad, eternally sad, those in purgatory. She saw many she had known, her friends and family. She grieved ever deeply for what became of them. Then she was received, this child Flanders born, before God on his throne, who told her she had to choose: stay with him in heaven, or rescue this dirty world. On a mission of hopeful suffering, Christina was to abscond with the pain of this earth by taking it upon herself, suffering great torment, never dying until the end of a long and strange life. So inspire the living and rescue the damned. Lead sinners back to the light, converted and remanded. From the doom of flames, all that pain would change to merit. When at last she returned through the gates of heaven, her reward for a career of impossible miracles in the 13th century. Christina the Astonishing, the Astonishing, the Astonishing. Christina the Astonishing, the Astonishing Christina. Immediately Christina told her followers that none should be astonished at the rituals as foretold, more extraordinary than the world has ever seen. Making penance for our souls, she returned to this world, this reborn orphan girl, no home or hearth of her own, content with such privations as to make your heart run cold. She was crushed by the millstone, broken on the wheel, tossed into the furnace where the fires made her scream. And the flames were quite real, frozen in the river Meuse, chased into the thorns while dogs tore her flesh. She was always healed. As the months and years ensued, each torture was an act of faith that she survived intact, always bloody but unscathed. The thinkers of the time were always left amazed. Christina the Astonishing, she is the patron saint of the crazy and insane. Religion may be about the same as a hypnotic trance. Don't be like Galileo, made to recant. Things that astonish us are revealed by analysis. We're all just some tainted fish, a knock on the head away from enlightenment. But no stigmata, no broken bones, no singeing or charring, no bloody thorns or scarring. From birth to dirt can admonish or abolish the suffering of Christina the Astonishing. So be sure and say your prayers for all she did for us. That may be our only, our own apotheosis. And as they told the stories, lo, these centuries hence, how Christina came down from the rafters to ease our righteous rage. She took on all our pain and saved us from ourselves, our eternal demise, separating all the sheep from all the goats in this shepherd's pie. Christina the Astonishing, the Astonishing, the Astonishing. Christina the Astonishing, the Astonishing Christina. Christina the Improbable. Christina. Astonishing. Christina the Astonishing. The Astonishing Christina. The peasant girl Christina, orphaned at 15. She was dead and almost buried when her body floated up to the ceiling of the church, to the witnesses who saw this act of levitation. She offered to the crowd this modest explanation. I had to rise above the smell of all that sin, because I could not stand the stench of those awful men. And stranger still was what she said had been revealed to her when she rose up to the rafters in her holy rapture. The angels showed to her the world that awaits, heaven and its joys, the torments of hell and hate, almost as bad, eternally sad, those in purgatory. She saw many she had known, her friends and family. She grieved ever deeply for what became of them. Then she was received, this child Flanders born, before God on his throne, who told her she had to choose, stay with him in heaven, or rescue this dirty world. On a mission of hopeful suffering, Christina was to abscond with the pain of this earth by taking it upon herself, suffering great torment, never dying until the end of a long and strange life. So inspire the living and rescue the damned. Lead sinners back to the light, converted and remanded. From the doom of flames, all that pain would change to merit. When at last she returned through the gates of heaven, her reward for a career of impossible miracles in the 13th century. Christina the Astonishing, the Astonishing, the Astonishing. Christina the Astonishing, the Astonishing Christina. Immediately Christina told her followers that none should be astonished at the rituals as foretold, more extraordinary than the world has ever seen. Making penance for our souls, she returned to this world, this reborn orphan girl, no home or hearth of her own, content with such privations as to make your heart run cold. She was crushed by the millstone, broken on the wheel, tossed into the furnace where the fires made her scream. And the flames were quite real, frozen in the river Meuse, chased into the thorns while dogs tore her flesh. She was always healed. As the months and years ensued, each torture was an act of faith that she survived intact, always bloody but unscathed. The thinkers of the time were always left amazed. Christina the Astonishing, she is the patron saint of the crazy and insane. Religion may be about the same as a hypnotic trance. Don't be like Galileo, made to recant. Things that astonish us are revealed by analysis. We're all just some tainted fish, a knock on the head away from enlightenment. But no stigmata, no broken bones, no singeing or charring, no bloody thorns or scarring. From birth to dirt can admonish or abolish the suffering of Christina the Astonishing. So be sure and say your prayers for all she did for us. That may be our only, our own apotheosis. And as they told the stories, lo, these centuries hence, how Christina came down from the rafters to ease our righteous rage. She took on all our pain and saved us from ourselves, our eternal demise, separating all the sheep from all the goats in this shepherd's pie. Christina the Astonishing, the Astonishing, the Astonishing. Christina the Astonishing, the Astonishing Christina. Christina the Impossible. of Christina.